Hello everybody, it's Chris, and welcome back, and today we're going to be reacting to Tabs, I'm sorry if I said it wrong, Brawl with an Asylum Escapee. Just the title alone is pretty much crazy, and I don't know where this is going to go, but we're going to see, and that's the reason we're here, to see what the fuck happened. And I'm low-key terrified, and low-key excited, on mixture of emotions. Okay. And are you gonna work time?
Clickbaiting. Oh, please. These dangerous things just tend to happen a concerning amount of times in my life. Okay, maybe I instigated a bit, but this is nothing to brag about. I kid you not. This happened not too long ago. Tis the season where all the crazy people come out. So I hope you guys had a better holiday than I did. This is gonna be one of those videos I'll add a disclaimer, but no one will listen to because curiosity, then regret over everything. So you know what's best for you.
I thought a cat was gonna pop out.
So if you don't know, I'm currently living in a dorm for this semester. I decided I wanted to go home for Thanksgiving break, you know, to spend time with the family as much as possible. Before I left, though, my roommates wanted to eat dinner with me first at like 11 p.m.
My God.
Like, I know it's mad late. It's why I left the dorm around midnight after eating.
Food.
By the time I got to the train station, it was 1 a.m.
Oh, God.
Take public
it's about 2 a.m. over here right now, right? Yeah, it's 1:35 a.m.
The train arrived shortly after, and I stepped inside. No one was in it, or at least that's what I thought
crazy
at first.
People.
It wasn't really
crazy
strange
people.
To me that it was empty inside, because for one, it was 1 a.m., not rush hour.
Yeah.
And second, it was only the second stop out of many other stops for that particular route. Not many people would have gotten on just yet. The first thing I thought was, wow, it smells like shit in here. I saw a puddle on the floor, which I could only assume was piss because of the foul odor. But it wasn't that
I thought vomit.
A lot of trains in this area often had a faint smell like that. This one just stronger than the others. The train started to move now, and I sat down to listen to my music when suddenly, in the corner of my eye, the guy sitting on the seat all the way at the other end gets up and starts cautiously walking towards me.
The heck?
Why didn't I notice him before? Oh well.
I like how our different word choices different.
Music. But the next thing I knew, he was standing right
is
in
he
front
right
of
there?
Me. And I mean like an inch away from my face.
Okay,
way
character
too close
design,
for
he's
wait
in
a
asylum escape, isn't he?
I realized the smell came from him. I don't mean to be rude,
God.
But no, who am I
did
kidding?
He pee?
I fucking
was he the one that
peed? At that moment. I glanced for a split second, noticed he was wearing a light blue gown while holding a few scattered newspapers in his hand.
So is it a felony
like
or a hospital
face,
person?
That would have been weird. I don't know, I thought. Maybe he just wanted to stand there, but I knew deep down that it was just my mind making excuses, so I didn't have to confront this guy. The fact that all the other seats were empty and he just happened to decide that he wanted to stand there and block the view in front of me was already a given to me that this wasn't just some coincidence.
Yeah, I don't trust that guy.
After like 30 awkward seconds of trying to ignore him, through my earphones, I heard heavy breathing.
Oh, God.
What the fuck?
But then
he sat down on the seat in front of me. Okay, cool. At least he's farther
right.
than he was
How
before.
About you close your
my
legs?
Eyes glued to the phone. But
oh,
then this
yeah.
happened. I heard loud moaning noises, groaning. Out of major concern, I looked up.
Okay.
Mind
please
you, this is the
me.
First time I got a good look at his face. Now
please
I don't mean to judge my appearance,
what I think
but I could just tell something was very off with this guy. His creepy
yeah.
smile wasn't helping him
okay,
either.
No.
But wait, if he's moaning, groaning, making all these struggle noises, and why is he smiling? Well, I found out why not too long after. Something
okay.
underneath
yeah.
his hand was making a repetitive up
right.
and down motion. See where
I
I'm getting
right.
at? He was trying
he's
to cover
talking.
What he was doing with his newspapers, too.
Well, give the guy some credit. At least he was trying to cover it up. Like, it could have
no.
been worse, but he doesn't even
no.
try
hit
to
hit him.
It
hit him. Hit him.
You're just lucky that he even bought it.
Let's just say now that we do not credit dumbass logic like that and try to justify those type of actions based on
yes.
what wasn't dumb.
Yes.
Let's
yeah.
be real.
Yes.
It doesn't cut the griminess any less than it is. This is
yes.
public transportation, not your house.
Even if
I hope you realize
people,
a bunch of
yeah.
people sit in that same
so
spot every day. So here this guy
her.
Was, beating
so
his
no.
meat right in front of me. All that came to my mind was, oh hell no. Nah, you buggin'. I gotta get off the next stop. I don't care which one it is. I'm out. I decided that I might as well report the guy to the police first and take a picture of him just in case they needed one to find a public wanker. So while he was
oh,
having fun playing
he
with the
show,
I pointed
liked
my phone
that.
Camera at him pretending to
take
it's
a flash on.
Suddenly, his beef whistle slips out of the gown accidentally with newspapers
oh,
scattered
God.
All over the floor. My phone almost drops by surprise. After he picks all of them up, He stood up once again, walked in front of me, and he just stood there. Man, you'd think
Why?
After all that, he'd have some
stood
shame in walking.
In front of you
and
after
again, if he's
stopping.
Willing to go that far to jack off freely on public transportation, probably not. After some very intimate tension, he finally decided to place his hand on my left shoulder. Right after he touched himself. Okay, now that was the final straw. The alarm bells in my head just told me to take action. Like now. Hey yo, what you doing? Don't be stupid and just sit there. Go kick his ass or something. I had no problem listening to Impulse at that moment. Alright, pause. Let me just say that I'm not fat, tall, nor intimidating in size whatsoever. Let me also say that I was never the type to be dependent on judging anyone's overall personality, intellect, capability based on their overall stature. Bullshit. Yet from my experience, a lot of people seem to do that without a second thought, including this jizzbag wanker. Oh look, a small girl sitting alone on the train. An easy target, bound to be weak and submissive,
Take
right?
Me, like,
no,
one of your
fuck
cups.
Off.
No.
My sanity was still intact, so I don't know what kind of thoughts were going through this guy's mind to give it a go, but there was an attempt. We are not about to play predator and victim on this empty moving train, because it's not at all as if actual passengers are going to be stepping in anytime soon to see what's going on. You wild. You a kook. Square up, B. Okay. Fine. Maybe this isn't how most people would feel in this situation.
So what did
honestly,
you do? Did you scream?
This really did set me off at the time. Especially since this wasn't the first time something like this happened to me. But rant over. Back to the story.
No. Okay.
This
That's
lord was really planning to do more violating right after he jerked off in front of me. Sorry to disappoint, but it's not happening. I saw a red
run.
When he touched my shoulder. I was in the process of getting one of those cheesy anime power boosts that only
gets
stronger from rage and the power of friendship. No, self-defense reflex, you know? My body was really just acting on its own at that point. I got up and shoved him down. The fuck are you doing? It didn't take him long to start making those Godzilla noises again, and he had this crazy look in his eyes when he turned back to me. He bounced back upwards and put his hand on me again. Get the fucking hint. We started struggling against each other with nobody on the train to break it up because it wasn't stopping anytime soon. Legit, this is a fight I could have gotten away with if I was 9 or even in a Jackie Chan movie. But this was real life. There was no law enforcement around to stop us.
Okay, yeah, that's scary as fuck.
He spat on my face a few times while yelling and got the few inappropriate touches he wanted during the process. Chill, man, are you doing this on purpose? Fast-moving train wasn't helping us much either, since we were pretty much tumbling back and forth. The whole time I was thinking, get Joe Peter away from me. This is ridiculous.
Yeah.
I can't believe this is the beginning of my Thanksgiving break.
Man, this is why you have pepper spray.
As soon as the next stop arrived, I threw him out of the train, making sure he couldn't come back in. He scrambled to return from the platform, but I kicked him for trying, and the doors eventually closed. When that was over, and the train started moving again, I just wanted to cool down a bit.
You sure, like, call the police?
The place I ended up getting off was mad shady, too. Ah, shit. I was farther
home
than I was before, so I ended up calling myself an Uber. The driver who was taking me home was chill, but he seemed high. Nonetheless, I'd take him over a junkie any day.
Yeah.
We had a pretty laid-back conversation during the ride, which eventually led me to mentioning what went down just a few minutes ago. Dude, this old guy in a light blue gown in an empty train tried to rape me before he picked me up. People are insane nowadays. And the driver went silent for a moment, and then he said,
"You do know there's a mental asylum around here with a good number of escapees, right? With the blue gown you just mentioned? I've seen a few of those guys around here too. You should be more careful going out around this time. If it were me, I would have kicked him in the balls and threw him off."
So a fight with a mental asylum runaway. Cool. Time to cross that off the bucket list. Needless to say, my parents were extremely concerned, didn't get much sleep that night, and I got myself a lovely lecture about this. Lesson here is don't go out on public transportation.
The police, you call the police,
after midnight,
I think,
especially if there's only one guy inside it and it smells funky as hell. I know that's common sense and all, but it's never happened to me before, so I guess I took my safety for granted. See, when you watch news about stuff like this happening, you never really expect it to happen to you. But once it actually happens, shit hits the fan. You gotta act without thinking. Trust your instinct and make a move, or it's gonna be game over before you know it. Other than that, recently we have a bunch of people congratulating me and the other animators for getting into YouTube Rewind. Thank you all. We couldn't have put our starting mark on this year's Rewind without you guys and your massive support.
Alright. So that was crazy. I don't know what I would have done in that situation. Probably kicked his ass or like shoved him with all the force that I had. And if I had a book in handy, I would smack him with the book. If I had this book, I would smack him with this book. But yeah, I can't believe she had to go through that. I hope she's okay. It looks like she's okay. And I hope that if you're in a similar situation, you get safety and you call the police and you have something in hand to beat the crap out of them with. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see all you strange and beautiful people in the next video. Bye guys.